Britain's rearmament programme proceeds apace, and nowhere more conspicuously than in the aircraft factory. Air Minister Lord Swinton. He is received by the chairman, Sir Charles Craven, and conducted through the huge plant where so much of the work for Air Force expansion is being carried out. The King's tour of aircraft factories is made informally and without public announcement, so that he may see for himself the working conditions at close quarters. As Duke of York, the King served in the Air Force, and the attention he gives to constructional details shows more than a knowledgeable interest in general rearmament plans. Closely guarded secrets were revealed to him as he examined minutely the new long-distance experimental bombers and studied plans and specifications.
The Wellesley bomber is a single-engine type, and she is a very formidable and fast machine. She has a retractable undercarriage, which you can see being lowered in the air, preparatory to landing. All these machines will be on view at the Hendon Air Pageant.
Meanwhile, another record flight attempt is in progress by three Wellesley bombers. Here they are, leaving for Ismailia, from where the machines will fly in the direction of Australia in an effort to beat the world's non-stop record of 6,306 miles set up by Soviet airmen. If and when they reach Port Darwin, they'll have beaten the Russians by 856 miles.
The new planes of the Royal Air Force are proving their mettle. A flight of Vickers Wellesley bombers, which took off from Cranwell, flew 4,300 miles non-stop in formation, and turning back at Bahrain on the Persian Gulf, landed eventually at Ismailia in Egypt. This means that there aren't many inaccessible military objectives which British planes cannot reach in an emergency.
And here are the first pictures of the RAF long-distance record flight to start from Ismailia. The Vickers Wellesley bombers fill up with fuel for a non-stop flight of over 7,000 miles. Fuel for the airmen is carried too, but in small quantities. Then they're ready for the takeoff at dawn, which, as you know, resulted in all three machines breaking the world record.
As a representative unit of the Royal Air Force, we are proud and honoured of being given the opportunity of visiting the Commonwealth of Australia.
So said Squadron Leader Kellett at Brisbane after he'd successfully led the three Vickers Wellesley bombers on their record flight from Ismailia to Australia. Their journey on across the continent was equally successful, and they were given a great welcome at the Brisbane Aerodrome. Falling in before their machines, the nine aviators were greeted by the Governor of Queensland, Sir Leslie Wilson, and the keenest interest was taken in the bombers themselves, for they've regained a world record for Britain. And this pleases Australia as much as the old country. Now, to prove that the latest types of British aircraft are actually in service, we'll return to Palestine, or rather Transjordania. Here, Vickers Wellesleys, similar to those which broke the long-distance record recently, are stationed at Amman, and patrol daily over the desert in cooperation with armoured cars and wireless vans. Since the campaign of pacification passed out of the towns and into the villages, the work of the Royal Air Force has resumed its major importance. The aerodrome at Amman is on the regular establishment, and while our aerial cameraman is flying with the Wellesleys, you will be able to spot it by its elaborate pattern of concrete runways.
Way behind, they're bombing up a Wellesley aircraft for raiding vital points on the Italian line of communications. Magnificent is the word to describe the work of the Royal Air Force during this campaign. Command of the air was one of the secrets of our success.